I'm Dr. Helen Czerski. I'm a physicist and I'm a research fellow here in mechanical engineering at UCL. And today they've let me loose in this amazing room, which is the Grant Museum at UCL. It's their zoology collection. And you would think, why would a physicist have any interest, apart from the fact that they're fascinating, in all of these animal structures, the bodies of animals? And the reason is that recently I've been doing quite a lot of thinking about how animals do things. We know they can do all kinds of amazing things. Some of them can see in the infrared, some of them can hear things that we can't hear. But how do they do it? So this is the same plastic model of the bones that are inside me. And we're built in a certain way, we're built out of cells, and those cells grow into structures that have functions. So our skeleton supports us, it gives us the rigidity to move around. But it's not just our skeleton which is important to us. We've got all kinds of other structures built into us. And one of the most fascinating things we have is detectors. We have detectors built into our bodies and we completely take them for granted. So we have eyes and ears, touch sensors, all made out of cells, structures that are doing different things. And we tend to assume that what we can see and hear and sense with those detectors is all there is. But that's not true. In this room right now, there are light waves travelling past me that I can't see. There are sound waves going past that I can't hear. There's lots of scents in the air that I can't sense. I don't have the right detectors built into my body. But some of these animals do. Let's have a look at how they do it.